Hello, welcome to the channel. Last week, we made a video using a GTX 1050 to show how an entry-level graphics card performs in emulation. We found that many games don't work properly, and others don't show significant differences. Today, we'll do the opposite and test my old GTX 970 SC, along with the new addition to the channel, an RTX 4070 OC with 12 GB of VRAM. This card is considered high-performance in today's standards. Will we notice many differences? But before we begin, if you enjoy this kind of content and are passionate about emulators and different systems, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to the channel to receive new videos every week.
This video is offered by the members and Patreons of the channel. Thank you for your support.
Thanks to all of you who watch the videos, comment, and leave your likes, I managed to acquire a new GPU, the RTX 4070. So, let's compare the GTX 970 SC, which was the old GPU of the channel, with the new RTX 4070. What do you think? Will the difference in PC emulation be absurd? Let's find out now. Just like in the GTX 1050 video, in this video, I will test the Ryujinx, RPC S3, and Xenia emulators, in the Canary version and the special build for Forza. Yuzu will be left out this time, as there was no support for the old driver to test it with the GTX 970 and Windows 11. Let's start by testing RPC S3 with some selected games. The first game will be Skate 3, which is optimized in the emulator. As you can see, both the GTX 970 and the RTX 4070 show practically the same performance in this game, with an identical average FPS, even running at 1080p with the FPS locked at 120. Now let's test heavier games that are not fully optimized in RPC S3 yet. Next on the list is Gran Turismo 6. Again, the results are very close, with the GTX 970 only 2 FPS below the average of the RTX 4070 at the end of the benchmark. The third game we will test is God of War 3, another title that is not 100% optimized in the emulator. However, my processor didn't bottleneck, maintaining maximum usage around 67%, and both GPUs had the same results once again. The last game to be tested is Metal Gear Solid 4, using the Illusion build, which is based on RPC S3 version 0.26. As in the previous tests, the conclusion repeats itself. There is no significant difference between the GTX 970 and the RTX 4070. Both GPUs work similarly and do not present any processor bottlenecks. In summary, when using RPC S3, the GPU, as long as it is a supported GPU by the emulator, makes little difference. For resolutions up to 1080p, an older GPU with 4 GB of VRAM is sufficient to handle the work smoothly. Of course, if the goal is to use higher resolutions, a newer and more powerful GPU will perform better, but it is still possible to achieve good results even with older GPUs. For example, I was able to run Gran Turismo 5 on the GTX 970 at 1440p. Now let's test Ryujinx, the emulator known for its accuracy with Nintendo Switch games. I've chosen 3 problematic games on this emulator: Bayonetta 3, Pokemon Scarlet, and Zelda Tears of the Kingdom. All tests were conducted at 1080p resolution with unlocked FPS. Among the 3 games, only Pokemon Scarlet is in a playable state on Ryujinx. I started by testing this game and freely walked around the 2 largest cities. There were no significant performance changes, and once again, there were no processor bottlenecks in either case. The second game tested was the problematic Bayonetta 3. Here, something unexpected happened. The GTX 970 had slightly better performance in terms of average frames. The stutters during gameplay and the audio delay in cutscenes were not resolved, even with the new GPU. Lastly, I tested Zelda Tears of the Kingdom, and here again the GTX 970 had slightly better performance. This piqued my curiosity, but upon seeing a post from the Yuzu team advising players not to buy the RTX 4060 Ti as it won't perform well with Yuzu, I had an idea of what might be happening in Ryujinx. It seems that Nintendo Switch emulators heavily rely on GPU bandwidth for better performance, which could explain this difference since the GTX 970 has a bandwidth of 256 bits, while the RTX 4070 only has 192 bits. So far, it is clear that investing in a new GPU solely for emulation purposes is not worth it. The performance gains are minimal and do not always guarantee a significantly better experience. It's important to consider other factors when deciding to upgrade your GPU, as emulation may not be the only aspect to consider. Now let's test Xenia, and based on my experience with this emulator, I'm confident we'll have different results. I'll start by testing the experimental version for the Forza franchise, starting with the first Forza Horizon. All tests will be run at native resolution with unlocked FPS. Finally, we had a completely satisfactory performance from the RTX 4070. During the tests in this game, the GTX 970 experienced bottlenecks, reaching 100% usage, with a maximum FPS close to 57. Meanwhile, the RTX 4070 worked comfortably, with only 40% utilization and reaching a maximum of 72 FPS. Another noticeable bottleneck here was the amount of VRAM, as all 4 GB of the GTX 970 were used, while the RTX 4070 reached around 5.5 GB of VRAM usage, which represents approximately 50% of available VRAM. The second game to be tested will be Forza Motorsport 4. Here again, the RTX 4070 had a significant advantage, reaching a maximum close to 80 FPS, while the GTX 970 was around 55 FPS. However, we can see that the GTX 970 did not experience significant bottlenecks in terms of VRAM or GPU usage. It's worth noting that the emulator version I'm using to run this game is from mid-2022 and still had limited optimization. Based on these results, it is clear that the RTX 4070 offers superior performance compared to the GTX 970 in Xenia. However, it is important to note that emulator performance can vary depending on the game and the emulator version used. Now, let's test the latest version of Xenia Canary, where we will test 4 games, with 3 of them known to be problematic in the emulator, and Skate 3, which is well optimized. Starting with Skate 3, we can see a significant performance gain for the RTX 4070, which showed an increase of up to 60% compared to the GTX 970. While the GTX 970 reached a maximum FPS of 100, the RTX 4070 reached 160. Once again, the GTX 970 experienced GPU usage bottlenecks, which was expected since the benchmark was run with unlocked FPS. The second game tested was Midnight Club Los Angeles, and I was surprised by the optimization it received over time. Now the game is in a playable state, even on the GTX 970, which achieved an average close to 50 FPS, with GPU usage bottlenecks. The RTX 4070, on the other hand, reached over 110 FPS, with an average close to 90 FPS. If you were looking forward to playing this game on PC, now is a good time. The third game was Sonic Unleashed, and on the GTX 970, there were still breaks in the emulator, while the RTX 4070 managed to run the game smoothly. However, it is important to be cautious as this game still has many issues in the emulator. It's a matter of luck, you may play for hours without any bugs, or the emulator may crash constantly. Once again, the results are presented as in a PC game. On the GTX 970, we had an average of 92 FPS at the end of the test, while on the RTX 4070, the average FPS was 143, representing an improvement of 55%. As expected, there were GPU core usage bottlenecks on the GTX 970. The last game we will test is Red Dead Redemption, and there were also significant improvements. Without making any graphical concessions, the GTX 970 achieved an average of 46 FPS, while the RTX 4070 nearly doubled that number, with an average of 75 FPS. Previously, to reach 40 FPS, it was necessary to disable vegetation, bloom, and reduce shadows to the minimum. In the latest version, just by unlocking the FPS, without making any graphical reductions, I was able to achieve a maximum of 50 FPS. In summary, we observe that the RTX 4070 offers significantly better performance compared to the GTX 970 in Xenia Canary. However, it is important to note that emulator performance can vary depending on the game, emulator version, and other factors. Guys, I have recorded additional tests to analyze the impact of high resolutions on some emulators, but these results will be presented in a second part of the video. I would also like to inform you that I have not yet recorded videos comparing the 0.0.28 version of RPCS3 with the new versions of Xenia Canary because I was waiting for the new GPU. I hope the video has been helpful to you, and if it was, please don't forget to leave your like. I wish you all a great week, and I'll see you in the next video.